Okay, good. Hi, everybody. I actually recognize some of you guys from our music classes. So that is awesome. Thank you for coming tonight. We're going to kick it off with a really cool ensemble. It's a percussion ensemble. And City Heights Music School is connected to the Youth Philharmonic Orchestra. And the percussion ensemble is high school and college musicians who are really, really good. So I hope you enjoy this introduction to the concert. And if you happen to know the names of any of the percussion instruments, feel free to write them in the chat and we'll see if you're right after the concert or after the performance. So let me get my clip ready. And it's called the Root Beer Rag and it's by Billy Joel. I don't know if anybody knows who he is, but he's one of my favorite singers. And here we go. So you see one of the instruments. There is a drum set, and see if you recognize the others. Thank you. All right. Did you guys, were you able to see that as well? I was wondering if maybe my video wasn't showing. Yes?
It was just a dark screen.
Oh no, you missed all the fun of it. Oh, what on earth?
But we heard it and I saw some kids dancing and I was dancing. It was sounded beautiful.
Oh, okay. Well, maybe I can pull that up again at the end so that you can see it, because that would make it easier to tell me what kind of instruments you saw. But if you're so good that you know what percussion instruments are, maybe you actually heard what some of them were. Yes, there was a xylophone and there's a piano. There was marimba, there's a drum set, and well, that's too bad. I'll make sure I pull that back up. But speaking of piano, piano is a percussion instrument. I don't know if you knew that, but there are these little hammers in the piano that hammer on the strings, and that's what makes a sound, and that's why it's a percussion instrument. So I actually have two piano videos that I want to share with you, and I will make sure that you can see them this time. And one is by a student who's been playing for, I think, just a year or two. And the music you just heard was kind of a blues rag style, and he's playing a simplified version of that. And this is called Blue Dragonfly. So give me a second to make sure I can share this. And here, whoops, let me get back to that. All right, there he is. Okay, here we go. Fortunately, that was kind of short. So could you all see that one? Yes. Okay. So I don't know if you could watch both hands at the same time, but they were kind of changing positions. And then at the very end, he went to a nice low note. The other song I have to share with you, you might recognize, is called Heart and Soul. And one of the great things about our classes is that we have all ages. So sometimes we have somebody your age who's learning to play a piano or a guitar with their dad or with their grandparents or a sibling. So the video you're going to see is one of our students with her grandpa who plays piano. And he, I think, was just vaccinated so they could finally get together. They hadn't seen each other in a year. So they sat down and played this song together. And let me grab it for you. It's going to be not that one yet. Here we are. Okay. This is Kayliani and her grandfather.
Good job.
She wasn't used to the new variation that comes up after you do the same thing like 20 times in a row. All right, so I'm going to introduce somebody who I forgot to introduce when I first started. And What you've just seen is piano, which is a, like I said, a percussion instrument, but it has strings on the inside of it that are hit by these little mallets. So we're gonna segue into some string instruments with guitar. And Mr. Mario Eguia is the assistant director for the City Heights Music School and also our mariachi director. So I'm gonna pass it on to him. Here he is.
We can't hear you, Mario. Are you able to unmute? Okay. Please bear with me. There we go.
Okay, there I am.
Thank you. Thank you for your patience.
No, no worries. Thank you. Now, I want to make myself big if you guys don't mind. Where is it? If you can pin, oh, there you go. I think I'm speaker view. Hey guys, thank you for having us here. My name is Mario Eguia, and I am the mariachi director here at City Heights Music School. I do teach other instruments as well, and I'm just gonna represent also some of our other teachers. I'm not the only guitar teacher, I'm not the only trumpet teacher, but I am one of the teachers. And I have several instruments that I would like to show you. And as Ms. Victoria mentioned, part of those instruments are string instruments. And the first one I want to start with showing you today is the guitar. Let's see, give me 1 second. Oh, actually I'm wrong. I wanted to show you a mariachi instrument if you guys don't mind. Now, raise your hand if you've seen this instrument before. Ooh, it has a rounded back, nice little tiny body. It kind of looks like an ukulele, right? This is actually called a vihuela. Can you guys say it at home? Vihuela. Kind of sounds like abuela if you speak Spanish, but it's a great instrument. So let me play something of the vihuela for you, okay? I'm gonna bring down the camera so you can see a little bit better. The first piece I'm gonna play for you guys is called El Cascabel. El Cascabel, or un cascabel, is a rattle. So a rattle, you know those things that you shake and they make noise? So this song is about somebody liking someone and the way, and they give them a gift. They give them a rattle. So every time they shake that rattle, they can remember that person, okay? This is called El Cascabel on the vihuela. Cascabel, con una cinta morada, yo tenía mi cascabel, y como la de oro ve, y como la de oro ve, se lo di a mi prenda amada, porque jugará con él allá por la madrugada. Cascabel. I hope you guys like that. Gracias, gracias. Now, one other thing I want to mention about this, I do want to reiterate, this one has 4 strings. wrong instrument. This one has 5 strings. And it does have a little bit of a sound, kind of like an ukulele. This instrument is used in mariachi, and as you guys heard right now, it is all about playing rhythms, and making it sound like a drummer. This is not scripted, but I want to add this to you guys because it is a Friday evening and I like to have fun on Fridays. One of the things that mariachi does a lot is play music from all over the world. This next piece I'm going to play from you is cumbia music. Cumbia music is from Colombia. Cumbia music is dance music. So you feel like you got to shake a little bit or you got to dance a little bit, this is the time. So you guys ready? If you're up at home, everybody gets to get standing and dancing. Here we go. Rosa María se fue a la playa, se fue a la playa, se fue a bañar. Rosa María se fue a la playa, se fue a la playa, se fue a bañar. Cuando estaba sentadita. Friday evening, getting the Friday started early. So once again, this is a vihuela, stringed instrument like the guitar. And it's actually from the family of the guitar. In fact, the guitar derives from the ancestor of this instrument, the vihuela, the Spanish vihuela. Now, let me grab the next instrument I want to show you guys. I love to show this instrument because, well, it looks like a guitar, but it's not a guitar. Let me back up so you guys can see, right? Can you guys see this instrument right here? A little bit bigger, right? It's like the mommy of the one I just played right now. Now, the way you say guitar in Spanish is guitarra. But if you add an on or ron to the end, make it a big guitar, that's the name of this, guitarrón. So you guys can say it at home, guitarrón, right? So this is the bass instrument, the one that plays the bass and keeps everybody together. It's kind of like the boss in a group. Now, I'm gonna bring the camera so you can see a little bit better over here, okay? You guys can see my lights are there too. Now, this looks like a guitar, right? It has six strings. But if you look at the strings, they're really, really thick. And instead of strumming like you would on the guitar, you actually pull them. Okay, so we can all play together. Let's play this together. And that is the sound of the guitarrón. So now you know a little bit of the sound of the guitarrón, okay? Next instrument is another one that I think you guys might know. I can't hold all of them at the same time. All right. Now this is the guitar I think you guys know. Yeah, this is the guitar. Six strings on the guitar. And it has a sound hole and all that stuff. Now, I want to play a little bit for you on the guitar. The guitar is really nice because it gives us a lot of variation in sound, a lot of different things we can do on the guitar. For example, let's see if you guys know this song, okay? I'm going to... Back at home. Ready? You guys ready? Let me see those thumbs up. Let me see those thumbs up, okay? Everybody's like, what's going to go? So here we go together, okay? Let's see if you know it. You're gonna sing with me. Para bailar la banda, para bailar la banda, se necesita una poca de gracia, una poca de gracia y otra cosita. Y arriba, y arriba, ay, arriba, y arriba, por ti seré, por ti seré, por ti seré. You guys ready? You guys know this part, right? One, two, three, four. Bam, 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 bam. Bam, 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 bam. Bam, 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 bam. Bam, 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 bam. All right, so that's a little bit of the guitar. You got to see me doing a little bit of melody with the pick. Right, you got me to see you see me play rhythm. You can also do other more fancier melodies like this. Right? And lastly, I want to show you a different voice of the guitar. The guitar, as you guys saw me play a little rhythm, a little bit of picking. Now I want to kind of play both of them for you, but for that I have to sit down. All right, and I'll bring the camera down with me a little bit. This next piece I will play for you guys is a Spanish piece called Romance Anonymous. And I'll show the guitar because I think that's more interesting right here. And put this. Here we go. And that is a little bit of Spanish romance. So you got to see three stringed instruments. We saw the vihuela, the small one. You guys remember that, playing a lot of rhythm. Then we saw the guitarrón, and of course, lastly, we finished with the guitar. So that is a little bit of that, and I'll see you in a couple of minutes after a couple more videos from Miss Victoria, and then we'll play more music together, okay?
Thank you for bearing with me while I, okay, we figured it out.
Okay, I am back. Okay, let me make sure I can see myself. There we go. So that was cool. And some of that music that Mario played is mariachi music, right? And in mariachis, you have another string instrument that you play up here. And I bet you could type it in the chat faster than I could say it. Maybe, maybe not. It's the violin, right? So up on our shoulder, we play the violin. And kind of like the vihuela, there is a bigger version that the violin can play with, and it is a cello, right? So I don't have a cello here to show you, but just like he showed you the guitarrón, which is much, much bigger, the cello is much, much bigger, and you'll see it in this video. This video is one of my private students and her mom. So they are playing a piece, kind of a medley from the Tchaikovsky 1812 overture. And here you go. Bravo! All right, so you notice the big sound of the cello and the higher sound of the violin. And she was even, I have a violin here. She was doing some pizzicato. Where you just get to pluck on the string, right? And the violin has four strings, just like the cello and the viola and the bass. And to give you a bigger sense of a string ensemble, I have one more video to show you, and it's with a recorder, a soloist, and her name is Lucy. And I believe she's about 14 years old in this video, and she's actually a world-renowned recorder player. So I know some of you guys have recorders at school, or you will have next year. I think maybe we're waiting a little while before we have recorders there. But generally, you might not think of recorder as like a really flashy instrument to play, but wait until you hear this girl. She's playing a Hungarian dance. Bring it up. And need to get to this one. Full screen. And impressive, wasn't it? Oh my goodness. And you could tell all these different points of contrast, which make it interesting, right? Sometimes she would play soft, and sometimes she played loud, and she played slow, and she played fast, and the orchestra behind her would just kind of alternate. And I don't know if you noticed some of the big bass, the double bass instrument, where they stand up and they have a big, huge bow that they're playing on their instrument. So the recorder, being one of the instruments that we teach, is actually one of the instruments that Mr. Mario teaches. And I'm going to turn it over to him for a little in-person demonstration, and then we'll be back. We'll see if we can get ourselves a muting. Oh, there he is.
There we go. There I am. Hello. I'm here back again to play some more music for you guys. Now, let me show you this cool instrument. I know some of you guys couldn't see the video, or most of you couldn't see the video. So we will share the link. Thank you for helping us with that. This is the recorder. And this is one of the instruments that Ms. Victoria mentioned that I teach. Now, I do not play like that person. So I just want to give you some basic things. There are three things that you need to be able to play the recorder well. One of them, number one, is wind, air. We need a lot of air. So back at home, you guys ready? Sit up nice and tall. Stretch out your arms to the top. Stretch out your arms, okay? And then drop them to the side. Just drop them to the side naturally. And then now roll your shoulders. It feels really good, right? It's like yoga Friday with music. And And then another thing I like to do is let your head do like some head tilts, head rolls, and you can feel the tension relaxing. Why do we do this? We do this because we need to breathe. And to breathe, we need to be relaxed with our muscles, our intercostal muscles and all that stuff. And we'll talk more about that in class one of these days, okay? But can you guys take a big breath for me? Let it out. Now, if you guys notice, when I took my breath, I did this. When we do that, that makes us really tight. Now let's do take a big breath, but now imagine this. Imagine your tummy is like a balloon that's gonna get full of air. So now your shoulders should stay nice and still. Look, I'm gonna take a big breath and my shoulders won't move. You see that? No movement of my shoulders. Can you guys try to do that at home? Relax. Take a big breath. Feel your tummy. Big breath more. 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 And then it comes out, right? Yes, that's good. That's how you breathe, okay? So we need air, right? Wind, air, right? The next thing we need is fingers. We're gonna get to it. We're gonna get to it. So once you have the air, you can start doing the first thing. You can just grab it from here, no holes. I'm just gonna put some air in the instrument very softly. And we get that sound, right? Okay? But now we're talking about fingers. Let's talk about fingers. Put up your left hand and put it in front of you like that, and then make an okay sign. Okay sign with the left hand. That okay sign, notice that hole in the back, is gonna go on the back of the recorder like that. And then you're gonna put your first finger right there on the first tone hole. That is gonna be your first note you would learn most of the time with most people. That is a B. Kinda looks like a B and an okay sign, right? So it works perfectly. Okay sign is a B. Now we're gonna play the first note. Imagine it. Can you guys get your big breath? Ready? Make your okay sign. Make it your okay sign. Put it on your imaginary recorder. Take a big breath. Okay. Now let's play a little competition right here. We're going to take a big, huge breath. You guys are going to blow out. Okay. And I want to play the note and let's see who can hold it the longest. You guys ready? Let's try it. Ready? Take a big breath. Ready? One, two, ready. That's a big breath. So we mentioned wind, breath, right? We need to breathe. It's very important. Number one. Second, we need fingers. Next thing, we need tongue. And what does that mean? When we play a sound, we can do this. See, all the notes are connected. But we sometimes need to play individual notes. You heard the player go, right? It goes really quick. So let me do the difference. Let me show you the difference. A lot of fast notes, right? And that is our tongue. And what we do, what we say when we do that, we say do. And it sounds funny because you're like saying do 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 do. Okay? Can you guys say it? Do 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 do. Like D O O. Do like Scooby Doo. Scooby Doo. Do 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 do. And then you can try it with when you take your break breath. Can you try that one more time? Now let's try on the recorder. See, and that's what you get. So we've learned a little bit of the recorder. I know you guys don't have one at home, but right now you learned the basics for basic recorder playing. Now, the next instrument I had to show that we missed showing you guys is another string instrument. So I'm going backwards, okay? Some of you guys might be familiar with this instrument. Who knows this instrument? Ah, I see some of you. This is a very popular instrument. It's played in Hawaii a lot, right? And a lot of people call it ukulele. And we'll talk about that word right now, but we'll talk about that right now. Let me play a little bit of strumming for you. Now I'm bringing it down so you can see a little bit more of the strumming. Notice that I'm holding it just with my hand. This is a very comfortable instrument to learn to play, especially if your hands are small, right? Okay. Just a little bit of strumming on the ukulele. You can sing. I love singing with the ukulele. It's really fun. But I want to talk about the word ukulele real quick. The word is actually pronounced ukulele. Can you guys say that? Ukulele. Now, it is my understanding, you should check, because we should always check our information, but it is my understanding that ukulele roughly translates into jumping fleas. And I was like, what? What do jumping fleas have to do with playing the ukulele? But it dawned on me, and I read a little bit of the history behind it. A lot of the times when people play it, they play like finger-picking patterns. So you can see, let me demonstrate a little bit. You see my fingers, how they move? It kind of looks like little jumping fleas, right? So let me play a little bit something now. Ukulele. All right, and I think Miss Victoria has a video for us to show us a little bit more of ukulele playing and a little bit of another wind instrument. Remember, the recorder is a wind instrument, the ukulele is not, but they can go definitely really well together.
Are we missing your audio, Victoria? I think that's my fault again. Are you with us, Victoria?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Here we go. All right. Playing flute and ukulele. So in these times where we're just on our own recording in our house, in our bedroom, in our garage, we can use some apps that allow us to play with ourselves. So our musician, Elena, who's actually one of our mariachi musicians, is learning the flute. She's only been playing since the summer, and she's just kind of picked up the ukulele. She's just one of those people who loves all instruments. And I think she plays the piano as well, some guitar, and she plays violin in the mariachi. So this is Elena playing Fly Me to the Moon. And now I seem to have jinxed myself because it's not playing. Huh. Okay. Well, you know what? I think Mario is switching instruments. Let me try this one more time.
I'll try it again. Okay.
Just the spinning wheel over and over and over again. I think my internet is maybe not so good tonight. Mario, do you want to jump to the next instrument? If we can unmute him.
Oh, can you guys hear me now? Yes, perfect, perfect. I'm gonna back up a little bit. Okay, so we were talking about wind instruments. We talked about the recorder. We talked in the video we're gonna watch is the flute, which is also a wind instrument. Now, another wind instrument, because it takes air, it's actually from the brass family. In mariachi, we use it a lot. It's actually a very popular instrument in really kind of most type of music, folk music, pop music. You guys probably know this. You guys know this? Thumbs up if you guys know this instrument. Ooh, who's seen this one, right? Very popular instrument. This is a trumpet. On the trumpet, we have the bell. We have our three valves. What I really love about my trumpet is because it's really old, the plating, the silver plating is falling off. Can you guys see that, how it transitions to silver? It's not meant to be like that, but that's how it is on my trumpet. This trumpet is actually older than me, which is really nice because you can see the material that brass instruments are made of, which is brass. So not much of a new thing right there. It's a brass instrument. But before I play on the trumpet, I would love to give you an idea of how to play the trumpet, okay? So you at home right now, have you ever seen when you get on a horse, well, in my case, the horse didn't like it. Have you ever seen when they go like this? Have you guys seen when they do that? Can you guys do that? I always love watching everybody do this. Yeah, because that's how you play trumpet. So we're gonna do it like this again, one more time. Now, imagine you're like a tiny little horse, okay? So you gotta control that, the big one, and make it small like this. You see how tiny that is? You can actually change the sound. You hear that? And it kind of tickles a little bit, and that is normal. Now, let me show you how to play trumpet. So on the trumpet, we have this part that's called the mouthpiece. It comes off very, very gently. You make your little tiny horse face or lips. You put the mouthpiece on your lips. Yes, you guys know that song, right? This is really how you play trumpet, believe it or not. This is just like a speaker with like different channels. That's all it is, frequencies, right? So mouthpiece, I'll play a little bit of trumpet sound for you guys, okay? Little bit of trumpet sound. Now, I would like, and I'm going to demonstrate a couple of more techniques that we use in trumpet playing just to make our sound a little bit different. One of them is vibrato. Vibrato is an Italian word, well, that sounds kind of like the English word, vibrato, or vibrate, which vibrate is like quavering or moving, right? So in vibrato, in the instrument playing, it makes it sound kind of like there are waves in the ocean. Wah, 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 wah. I imagine waves in the ocean like that. They made noise, all right? So let me demonstrate. Single straight note. Straight tone, right? Just straight and regular tone. And that's always, we always want to make that. But now we're going to do vibrato. You guys hear that? Wah, 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 wah. So why do we do that? Sometimes because we want our playing to sound like somebody singing. Sometimes we do it to express a little bit more of what we're trying to play. So let me give you a demonstration. It changes the way it sounds, right? Now, another thing we like to use in playing trumpet are tools that we have. Now, I don't know if you guys have been to Thrifty Ice Cream, but I have. And it kind of looks like this, right? When you get your ice cream cone. So these cones are called mutes, and mutes are used to change the sound in the trumpet. So you put it, you can see the shape, how it goes in there, that cone shape, it goes in there. Let's see if you guys can appreciate the difference. Very different sound, right? And just for fun, I'll show you the different one. This is called a wah-wah mute. Now, I'm gonna play a short little song for you guys. Let me see if you guys know it. If you guys know it, I want you to put a thumbs up. This is a very, very, very famous song. Are you guys ready? Let's see if you guys know it. Let's see if Ms. Crystal Grovner knows this, okay? Don't get mad at me after I play it. Okay, here we go. That song. I told you it was a famous song. So there you go, folks. That is the trumpet, a little bit of the trumpet, or the brass family, which continues to be a wind instrument. However, normally we call the other wind instruments like the flute and the saxophone reed instruments because they use a different mechanism of playing. But that's for another day, okay? That was the trumpet for today. And I think Ms. Victoria has another video for you guys.
Okay, I'm actually thinking, since I don't have great success sharing my videos this evening, we might skip that part and just go to questions. So let's take a look in the chat, or maybe Crystal, if you wanna share any questions that you've seen pop up. We will show you some of the mariachi music in our Cinco de Mayo presentation in May. So make sure you catch us then. You can also visit our website, which is cityheightsmusicschool.org. And we have a whole bunch of videos on there. And I'll send the links to the percussion and the other videos that you missed as well. So are there any questions we can answer?
Thank you so much, Victoria. We don't have any questions yet, so I'll give everyone some time to think of anything they can think of to ask you while you're with us. I just put in those two links to the YouTube videos in the chat.
Great, thank you.
And also to City Heights Music School. Does anyone have any questions?
I saw a question.
Who is it? It's Miss Victoria Hill.
Gabriel and Alexa O.
Okay.
No, that I don't know. It moved, but the question was, how long has Mr. Mario been playing? That's me. how long have I been playing? I'll let you do the math. I have been playing since I was 14, and I am 35 years old now. Do the math. It's a good question. Cross-curricular.
Awesome. Miss Brielle, do you have a question?
Do you guys know how to play the piano?
Miss Victoria's better, but I do know how to play a little bit too myself.
Yes, I started playing violin first. So when I was 4 years old, I had this little violin. It wasn't even a violin, it was a box with a ruler taped to it and a chopstick. And so I learned how to hold that and treat it really well so I wouldn't break the real thing when I got it. And then my mom always played piano. So I started playing when I was in fourth grade, and she played a lot of jazz and blues and Mozart, you know, classical composers. But yeah, I enjoy playing piano.
I'm in fourth grade.
Fourth grade, yes. You definitely need to start playing piano.
I just need more piano.
More piano.
Miss Hills has her hand up.
Yes, let's go to Miss Hill, Miss Victoria Hill, then Brielle, and then Allie.
What is mariachi music?
What is mariachi music? Is that your question?
Yes.
Ooh, that is an awesome question, Victoria. And I'm not even gonna give you a good answer, but I'm gonna answer it. Listen, mariachi originates from Mexico. That is a fact, or that's an undisputed fact. Mariachis come from Mexico originally, over a couple hundred years ago. However, mariachis can be found everywhere in the world. And I can tell you that because I've traveled all over the world playing mariachi, and I've met other mariachi players. We are a very adaptable ensemble of musicians. Ensemble is a group of musicians, and we can play music from all over the place. And really, mariachis nowadays play music from all over the world. So when people ask me what is mariachi, I always tell them mariachi is really a way of being. It's an attitude. And it's a positive attitude about being open to so many different kinds of music, about being open to different cultures of the world. And to me, that is what mariachi is. Because when I was in the Navy, this is a little unknown, well, not unknown, but I was in the Navy, I got to experience many different types of world, people from all over the world. And I always played a little bit of, you know, my instrument, and everybody always knew mariachi everywhere. So I always tell people mariachi is an attitude of just being open to culture and just music in general. So I think it's very cool. Really great question, terrible answer, but now you know my answer.
Okay, Miss Brielle, do you have another question? And Allie.
Ellie, where are you at, Ellie? Oh, there you are. We can't hear you, Ellie.
We're having trouble hearing you, Ellie. Let's see if you can type it into the chat, okay? Because you're not muted, but we can't hear you. Let's see if you can type it into the chat. Does anyone else have any questions? Okay, I'm gonna give Miss Allie a little bit of time to to put her question in the chat. Mariachi is the best. I want to take this time to remind everybody, or to actually let everybody know, that May 7th, we'll be doing a mariachi night with the PTSA and City Heights Music School with Mario. And Mario, do you want to share a little bit about what your mariachi does?
So, I do different types of mariachis. Here in San Diego, I play with three different groups, three different mariachis. One mariachi is my student group, Victoria, and our student group, Mariachi Victoria San Diego. You can find us even on Facebook if you want to. And that mariachi is from students ranging, I believe, now from 9 to 84 years of age. 9 to 84 years of age. We all play. We're open doors to everybody. The other group that I play with is a gig group, what we call chambas. Gigs are like jobs that you go play, you know, like little concerts for people at their backyard, just like that. And that's just a four-piece group that we go. We have some great musicians that I play with, and we just play it hundreds of songs, quite frankly. And then I have a show group that I play with, a professional group called Champaña Nevin. Sometimes we play with San Diego Symphony. That's the one I've traveled the world with, playing different concerts and different stages, right? A little bit of what you'll be seeing on Thursday, or our plan is, I would love for you guys to see some of my professional musician friends, if I can get them to appear. But at least, of course, I will play for you. We're going to be in our full suits, wearing our suits and stuff like that. So you get to see a little bit of what mariachis wear, the kind of uniforms that we wear. People call them costumes. They're not. They're uniforms, right? And you will also hopefully be hearing a few of our students, some of their younger students playing guitar, playing violin maybe, or singing songs for you guys. So hopefully on May 7th, I get to see all your faces, and we get to share music. And just share a little bit of the style and the feeling of mariachi music.
We're so excited for that. Okay, two questions in the chat. One is from Allie. How many instruments do you play, and what is your favorite instrument? Great questions.
Okay, can I answer, Ms. Victoria? Yes. I will tell you the truth. I only really play two instruments. I play vihuela and guitar. I know the other instruments because I've had to learn them, you know, academically when I went to San Diego State. I was forced to play piano, by the way. It's beautiful, but I was like, here, you got to learn it. I'm like, okay. But I do play, my real instruments are guitar, like I say, and vihuela, the little one, remember, that kind of looks like the ukulele. My favorite instrument. This is a crazy answer. My favorite instrument is all of them, but more specifically, so I can answer you more specifically, is the instrument, whichever it is at any given time, that is the one that I'm learning to play. For example, right now I'm really working on learning to play the violin, because I think it's important to play. If I want to be teaching mariachi, I need to understand the violin, the mechanics, right? So right now it's my favorite instrument, because it's the one that's challenging me so much every day and making me better as a person, as a musician. So whatever instrument I'm learning to play is my favorite instrument of the day.
I would say that my favorite instrument is probably the violin too, which I've played all my life. I also play piano. And then I think the great thing about playing music is that you can really figure out other instruments pretty easily, or more easily. So you can understand like the logic behind playing an instrument. So I play viola. I shouldn't say I play viola. I know how to play viola. I don't play very well. Cello, some guitar. I love playing guitar. And my husband learned probably 10 years ago, and he practiced for hours. And I started practicing too, just because it's so interesting and it's so nice to listen to. So those are really my instruments. I play some recorder, but that's it for me.
Awesome answers. Thank you so much. Well, I'm going to invite everyone on the Zoom to unmute yourselves for a little bit and to give a big round of applause to Mario and Victoria. We are so grateful for the time and music that you shared with us today.
Okay. It was a blast.